another video. We are going to make a panda hiding behind a grass. This is an artwork that I really want you to have fun with paints, like really enjoy painting. So we are going to start straight away with the paints. I will show you what materials we need. So we are going to use some paints, and I'm going to start with some green. The green, blue, yellow, and some blue and the purple. So I have those open, those colors open, and some oil pastels. We are going to use like a medium size round brush, and then a big flat brush. So those are the two, and some paper towels. So we also need some paper towels, some water in the container, and this is the artwork that I'm planning to show you. It's good for age between, like, say for example, like between 5 to 7 years old. So I'm going to show you a quick video, but feel free to pause in between and take your time to do it. We will need a little bit of a drying time between the colors, so feel free to pause the video and wait like 2 or 3 minutes till your paint is dry, and then go to the next step. So to start from fresh, like start new, we are going to take some water, and my water is green because I was already painting, but the clean water will be really, really recommended for this step. And we are just painting with the water. So we are going to start with the sky part first, and I'm painting 2/3 of the paper with just clear water, and then I'm going to dip a teensy bit, taking a teensy bit of blue, and we are painting side to side, and then slowly and gradually we are going up, like getting it lighter and lighter as it goes up. I have also taped my paper. I have taped my paper, so it is almost like 2/8 of an inch on all 4 sides, so it gives a nice frame after the artwork is done. So if you have a paper tape, feel free to tape the paper, and this is a Bristol paper, but you can also use a watercolor paper or some paper that's nice and thick that can hold water really well. Okay, so I do have some light blue going up. It's not seen so clearly in the video. And then I'm taking a little bit of a dark blue now, and adding some strokes. And we have to do this part when the water is wet, so then they will be smudging and mixing together. And then a little bit of purple, and similarly, like, we're just adding some strokes. If you get a lot of patch of color like this, we can get it out, we can bring it out by using a paper towel, because we don't want so much. My painting is also getting dried up, so I'm using some watered down paper and trying to smudge my purple with the blue. And this is the sky, so feel free to add however strokes you like, because every day sky is a different color, different patterns. So don't feel like your drawing, like your painting is getting messed up or anything like that. So I'm just going to use a little bit of a blue to smudge the purple out. So we got our sky part, and then I'm going to use some green for the bottom. And again, this is the watered down paint, so use a lot of water and less color. So once we have this, we are going to add the strokes like this for the grass, because we want to show the vertical grass like this, and it is long on one side and then shorter on the other, shorter in the middle, and then we can make some more long on the two sides. So we want to show the panda hiding, and that's the reason we are adding a tall grass on one side and then a shorter grass in the in some portion. So now we don't need the flat brush, and we are going to switch to the medium size, and I'm using my dark blue paint. And then for to start with, I'm adding the strokes from down up, because that's how the grass grows. It grows from the ground and it goes up. So we are adding some strokes from ground up. And then some smaller, shorter lines in the middle part or on the one side. After blue, I'm using the same brush for the green. Ideally, best way to do it is like scoop your colors out and use the color palette. That's the best way to do it. Otherwise, you will end up mixing all your paints. I'm doing this because I know how to not mix my paints and still use different colors. But I would really recommend to use the palette, okay? If you don't have palette, you can also use a tracing paper or a acetate sheet, like a plastic acetate sheet. That works perfectly fine too. So after green, we are going to add some yellow lines, and I'm going to wash my paintbrush for that. Okay, so now we are going to start with some yellow lines. And now I am starting to add lines going from up and down, and adding, swirling my brush as I come down. So that will help with thin, long and short lines. We don't want too much yellow also, so and then the last one is some white. So again, I'm washing my paintbrush using the paper towel. We always wipe it and then go, because there is still a color, so we want to make sure there is no color in the brush before we start with the white, okay? And then now I'm adding some lines for the highlights. And again, we wash the paintbrush, wipe it. And I'm going to start with the head of the panda now. So I'm using the white and making a sort of an oval or a circle, and then painting the white inside. Okay, we can still see through the sky, and that is okay for now, because we are going to use the oil pastels also for the same thing. And then the lastly, we are going to use some brown for the body part. So right, if we draw a line, like a horizontal line in the middle of the head, we want to pick those points. And then we are coloring brown for the body of the panda. Now I'm not coloring on the grass, I'm only coloring on the blue, which is the sky part. Also adding some circles for the ears. Now these circles are on the white, they are not outside the white like the cat, but they are on the white and going little bit outside of the white. we are also adding some slanted lines for the eyes and then the triangle. Maybe triangle will be here. So we need some space. So the top triangle, this one is by mistake. And so I'm going to bring in my paper towel and wipe it out. Because we need some space for the notch. And then I'm also going to cover it once it dries. You can cover it with the white paint. So if we make a mistake, you can, that's still okay. And then we can fix it once the paint dries. So now while the panda is drying, I'm going to get my oil pastels and going to start with some white, and we are adding some clouds here. Now please remember, make sure your artwork is nice and dry before you start oil pastels. So I'm just taking some time to draw the clouds so my paints on the panda dries up really well. So I'm making a line in a circle. It's a different types of circles going in a line. So it's a random circles, but you're making it thicker in the center and thinner on the sides. So we got some clouds, and I'm hoping that my panda is dry. So we are using the oil pastel and coloring it over the white, because the panda's face is like fluffy and nice and soft and fluffy. So we want to give that effect, and that is the reason we are using some oil pastels on panda to show that texture, to bring that fluffy and soft texture out. So my paints are a little bit wet, and so they are mixing with the oil paints. But when you are painting, take some time to dry and then you can use the oil pastels, okay? And then I'm switching to black, and I'm adding some black on the brown. And I'm using a zigzag pattern, so we can still see the brown, but then we can also see some texture of the fur. And then black for the eyes, and then on the triangle of the nose. So it's upside down triangle, and then I'm adding small strokes on the brown to show the fur. So again, the brown is wet, but you can please take time before you add your oil pastels so it dries up really well. The last bit, we are going to add the nose part. So it's like an upside down heart. So I'm making a heart shape, but not joining the corner. So we are using the gray to add that part, and then we can smudge it with the white. So we don't want to see the line, but we want to see like a shape that's coming out of the mouth. If you don't see very clearly, you can again add that gray so you can define the shape of the nose and the mouth, and then we come back with some brown to add the mouth. And I'm also adding some black here. So that's pretty much it. And then we want the grass to be really dense. So if you like, you can also add some more lines using your oil pastels to make it more dense. And feel free to use any colors. See, like I started with a very, very dark blue, and then I'm adding some green.